It all began with a kettle. James Watt's aunt was angry. Rather than reading a good book, the 15-year-old sat around the house all day just watching the kettle boil. He'd lift the lid, look inside, see the steam rising, see the steam condensing on the inside of the lid. Now, what the aunt took as idleness was really the keen attention of a junior scientist, a man who would, one day, invent the world's first really efficient steam engine. James Watt grew up to be a maker of scientific instruments at Glasgow University. One day, he was asked to repair a model of an early steam engine, the Newcomen engine. The model had literally run out of steam. The Newcomen engine had been in use since the beginning of the 18th century. It was mainly used for pumping water out of mines, but didn't work terribly well. The engine operated on the principle of a vacuum, created by condensing steam in a single cylinder. However, it consumed a huge amount of coal to produce not a lot of power. This is where Watt had a simple, ingenious idea, a real leap forward. In his engine, the cooling process was separated from the cylinder. And here we have his condenser down here, a wonderful thing, which means that the cylinder upstairs remained hot all the time. Steam from the boiler enters the cylinder at the top, pushing down the piston inside. At the end of the stroke, the pressure in the cylinder is equalized, and the natural weight of the pump rod pulls the piston up towards its starting position. As it rises, a valve releases the steam into the bottom of the cylinder. On each downward stroke, this steam is drawn into the separate condenser, where it is condensed. This process creates a vacuum, which pulls down the piston as the steam above pushes it down. This amazingly efficient use of steam means that the Watt engine consumes less than a third of the amount of coal used by the Newcomen engine. It's also twice as powerful.
The awesome power of this engine raised a ton of water with every stroke. That's nearly 4 million gallons a day. But Watt's engine was to become more than just an efficient super pump, was to drive the transformation of every workplace in the country.